Welcome to Berwick Mitsubishi. My name is Nathan and today we're doing a walk around video of this 2016 Subaru Impreza in a Gen 4. Now, as you can see, the condition of the car is quite exceptional, but we will cover the actual condition of the paintwork on the outside and some of the features on the interior, as it is not your standard base model. Now, starting off at the front end, you've got this signature Subaru badging right in the middle there with this really nice split grille look. It does allow for a little bit of extra airflow through the top there, and again, just clears up the actual grille and gives a really nice effect to the front end. Now, as it is a black car, it does help having these really nice chrome badgings around. It does break up the color a little bit and adds a little bit of detail to the front end. Now, the actual front bar is in very good condition. There's very minor marks considering the age of the car, but the car's actually been looked after really well by the previous owner. And it is actually, this car itself is actually quite an ideal car for a first car owner. Now, taking a look at the headlight, you've got a really big headlight globes there with your indicator lamp built in just on the side there. And along the side, you've got Subaru's signature daytime running lights. It does add that extra visibility during the day. It gives a really nice aggressive look to the front end. Now, just below that, you've got your headlight washers built in. And on the front bar here, just under this really nice chrome splitter, you've got your fog lights fitted in there. It is going to help when you are driving around on those cloudy, foggy mornings. Now, coming across to this first alloy rim, you got the really nice Subaru hubcap in the middle there and the genuine Subaru rims. Very signature look as well. And you can see the condition of the rim is very good. There's no major stone chips or marks on the paintwork and no gutter rash either. And just on the tires, you've got plenty of tread on these Potenza tires as well. Now, as you come across the side of the car, we'll note you do get your color match side mirror with the color match door handle with the really nice chrome finish through the middle there. Now, it does give a really nice detail. Again, being a black car, it does help having these little small little details on the side of the car. And you've got your indicator lamp built in just into the side of the of your side view mirror. It does clear up that quarter panel, but it also elevates the actual headlight indicator light to give indication to all the other drivers on the road. Now, one thing I will note is the car doesn't actually come with tint. It is what we call privacy glass. It does add a little bit of detail to the car and provides a bit of privacy from actually looking, but it doesn't actually give you any UV protection or heat reduction. Now, it is a keyless entry car, so if you just simply put your hand inside the door handle, it does unlock as well. So really nice attention to detail by Subaru. Now, taking a look at the driver's side of the car, you've got really nice leather seats, great bolsters, great condition on the actual leather as well. No major cracking or wear or tear marks on the leather, and no sun damage either. And you've got your electric seat controls to adjust the seats. And just down here on the carpet, very good condition on the carpet, no tears or damage to the carpet itself, as it does come with your genuine Subaru Impreza floor mats as well. They're just in the boot. And just on the scuffing here, very minimal marks, but the actual paintwork is in very good condition. Now, if you take a look at the door card itself, as you can see, there's no damage from any people kicking the door open or getting lazy when they get out. So the previous owners actually looked after this car really well, and it's just a testament to the actual condition of the car. Now, as you come across the side, one thing I will note is the paintwork presents really well. I don't know if you can tell, but it almost reflects like a mirror. I highly recommend you take advantage of our glass coat product. It is going to give a lifetime warranty on this beautiful black paintwork and make it 10 times easier for you to clean as well. Now, coming over to this second alloy, again, it's very signature Subaru look, and again, great condition on these rims. Very minor mark here. However, the rest of the rim presents really well, and again, plenty of tread on these Potenza RE003s. Coming across to the back end of the Subaru, again, very iconic look. You've got your really big bold headlights that do cut across the side of the car. Just add for the extra visibility for all the other drivers on the road. And you've got your chrome Subaru all-wheel drive badging with the Impreza badging on the side there, and Subaru badging in the middle there. Now, it does come with a high-mounted brake light. It does help when you are braking, and it gives a bit of extra indication to the drivers behind you. Now, it does come fitted with the reverse camera mounted just under there. So everything you could possibly need in this car. Now, taking a look in the actual boot, again, plenty of space in the back end. It does come with a cargo liner. It does help provide that extra privacy. If you do have anything, any valuable items stored in the boot, people can get pretty nosy these days. And as I mentioned, you've got your genuine Subaru Impreza Subaru mats, floor mats as well. And if you just lift up the fold here, you've got your space saver spare wheel and all the tools you'll need to actually jack the car up and change it over. And now, this tire has actually never been used, so it does give you a bit of indication that the car has been looked after really well and driven quite carefully. And if you just look on the back there, again, no damage or marks from anyone shoving anything into the boot too quickly. All the plastics are in very good condition, so the car actually presents really well. Now, if you come across to the passenger side, you can see very good condition on the car. And again, coming over to that third alloy, very good condition on the rims, very, very minor mark there, and another one on this side. But again, it's very superficial and plenty of tread on the rear tires on there. And as you look at the passenger side of the car, it just really gives you an example of how well this car presents. Could do with a little bit of a clean, but it hasn't been the best day today, and the car has been stored outside. Now, if you take a look on the fourth and final alloy, again, great condition on the actual rim, very minor gash here, but considering it's the one that generally gets damaged the most, it actually presents really well. Now, there's not much I needed to really tell you guys. The car is really good condition. It is a great car for a first time owner. I do highly recommend you take advantage of the other options to actually protect the car. Now, what we'll do is pop the hood and take a look inside. Now, taking a look inside the engine bay of the Impreza, what we have here is Subaru's iconic four-cylinder boxer motor with a 2-liter capacity. As you can see, it does present really well in the actual engine bay, in very good condition as well. Now, this is fitted with a 6-speed automatic gearbox, do make the shifts quite nice and smooth, and plenty of torque and power behind this boxer motor as well. Now, this car does have a 5-star ANCAP rating with 7 airbags, so plenty of safety for the actual size of the car and for all the passengers inside the cabin. Now, this motor itself, being the boxer motor, does produce 110 kilowatts with 196 newton meters of torque, so plenty of power for a full payload of people. And as I mentioned, it is a petrol fuel tank with a 55 liter capacity. Now, this has a combined fuel consumption of 6.8 liters per 100 kilometers with an average fuel distance of 809 kilometers off a full tank, depending on how you drive. So very economical car. Taking a look inside the Impreza. Now, this isn't just a standard Impreza. It does come with a few added little features and benefits. Now, on the right-hand side of the door, you've got really nice door card, very good condition on the actual plastic. And just on the armrest here, you've got a really nice leather-wrapped armrest just behind the actual controls. And up here, you've got all your power window settings with your driver's side being fully automatic up and down, and the rest of them just being your standard up and down power windows. Just above your controls are your central locking controls if you did want to keep the car locked or unlocked, and you've got your power windows as well in case people are playing around with the mirror windows in the back seat. Now, just above that is your toggle for your power mirrors if you did want to adjust them. And coming over to the right hand side of the actual dash, you've got the most important button here, your stop start engine button. Now, as I mentioned, it is a keyless entry car, so that button is there to turn on and off the car. You've got your illumination controls for the actual head unit and the little display up there. And just next to that is your traction control button, which you can turn off. However, it is an all-wheel drive car. I would recommend you just keep it on. There's no need to be trying anything extra. And just next to that is your auto off and on. Now, what that does is save you a little bit of fuel. If you are stopped at the lights, it does shut off the car and save you a little bit of added fuel. Now, on the right-hand stalk here, you've got your left and right indicator, very comfortable toggle actually, and you've got your fog light controls and your automatic headlights. Now, as I mentioned, automatic, you can just leave it in auto. The car's gonna do everything for you and sense when it is coming to a darker environment, it will just turn on automatically. And on your left-hand side, you've got your wiper and washer fluids for your front and rear with them being automatic as well. So you can just leave it in there and the car is gonna sense when there's water on the car and just automatically turn on for you. Now, coming to the steering wheel, you've got this really nice, comfortable leather stitched steering wheel, very soft padding as well, nice and easy to hold. And you've got, on the right-hand side, all your cruise control settings with your on and off and your set. And on the left-hand side are all your media controls for your head unit and your Bluetooth call and reject for your mobile phone. Now, just below that, you've got a little control that does let you flick to the different options in the little display in your head unit. And above that is another little control that does let you flick through the different options as well in the actual head unit itself, and previously I meant cluster. Now, just behind that, you've got your paddle shifts for your sports shift gearbox. I will touch on that when we go over to the gearbox. However, if you just look at the center console here, you can see that there's two little screens up there. One on the left does display your dual climate control settings, so your driver and passenger can have their own climate. And the little screen on the right there just has a few other little settings. There is a little control for it just up here. You can flick through your fuel consumption, mileage, power dispersion, and just a clock if you wanted to keep it nice and simple. Now, if you come over to the head unit, as you can see, it does come with inbuilt navigation. Now, you do notice we are at 20 to 32 Kangen Drive, so do come check us out if you've got some time. And if you go over to the home, you've got your full apps connectivity, your maps, and your audio for your Bluetooth connectivity, as well as your AM, FM, and your CD, as well as auxiliary. So the car comes with pretty much everything you could possibly need. Now, coming below that, as I mentioned, you've got your dual climate control settings with all your toggles to adjust the fan speed and a little display for it up there. If you come below that, you've got a little bit of storage with your auxiliary input and two USB charging ports if you did want to charge your phone, and a little 12 volt socket as well. Again, it is not a cigarette lighter, as we don't encourage people to smoke in the cars, but it does have that added 12 watt if you did want to charge anything. Now coming down to the gear shifter, really nice leather wrapped gear shifter, very comfortable to use. If you pull it down to reverse, you do see that really nice clear rear view camera, and it's got the rear bar just under there, so very clear indication on the camera, and you've got your guiding lines as well. As I mentioned, if you pull it down to drive, being the sports shift, you can flick it to the right and it does let you flick through the gears manually yourself. However, you can just leave it in drive and the car is just going to do everything for you. Pulling it up to park, you got a little bit of storage here for your keys, maybe if you wanted to keep it in there, maybe something else. And you've got little added storage here with two cup holders. Now you can just take out this compartment if you just wanted a full storage space. And just next to that is your manual handbrake, really nice and comfortable to use. And behind that is your heat warmers, so your high and low setting for your heat warmers. So can just, on those cold mornings, it does help to have this. And just behind that, you've got your center armrest, center console armrest, and you can just lift it up, and you've got a little bit of extra storage there with another 12 volt socket in there as well. So plenty of storage and power inputs for the actual car. And if you just look behind, you've got another USB, other two USB ports as well for the passengers in the rear seat. So you can see the car is pretty much fitted with everything you could possibly need, and the actual condition of the interior is quite exceptional. The previous owner has done a really good job in looking after the car. As I mentioned, it is a great ideal first car for anyone, with plenty of safety components for the passengers. And now one thing I do recommend is do take advantage of the glass coat and lifestyle pack. What that's going to give you is a lifetime warranty on the actual leather inside the car, and we can tie that in with the glass coat and tin and give you a nice little bundle that's going to just preserve the actual car and give a bit of longevity. Now one thing I did forget to mention is the car does come with a sunroof, so really nice feature as well. And you can just control that all from here. That's just your tilt control, and this one's to actually open it if you wanted to cruise around with the window down on a nice day like today. You can just pull it up, it does close automatically, and again, as I mentioned, the tilt option as well. So as you can see guys, a car presents really, really well on the interior and the exterior. What we're going to do now is just wrap up the video. For watching the walk around video on this 2016 Subaru Impreza in a Gen 4 model. Now if you do have any questions in regards to the car or wanted to test drive, the number to dial is 9907-0555. Now just before I go, this car does qualify for our premium mechanical protection plan. Now what that offers is 5 years extended protection on 181 electrical and mechanical components of this car, and it does come with the added benefit of 10 years roadside assistance. It's great value for money. It is going to make sure the car is looked after nice and well, and in case you do get stuck in an emergency, there is someone there to help you at all times, no matter where you are. And I also highly recommend you take advantage of the lifestyle pack. And what that does come with is a lifetime warranty on the actual leather on the interior, as well as your paint protection for your exterior and the window tint. I do highly recommend you speak to us about these options, as it is going to help protect your car. Now these are at an additional cost, however if you are using our in-house finance, I'd love to introduce you to our business managers Julie and Mario, who show just how minimal these will affect your repayments. And lastly, please check out our Google reviews. With over 1,000 reviews and sitting at 4.8 stars, it gives you the assurance that you are dealing with the right people and the right kind of business. Now, as I mentioned, if you did have any questions in regards to the car, the number to dial is 9907-0555. My name is Mathan, and remember, Barrick Mitsubishi, love that experience.